your adoption by our Father, and your pilgrimage to your salvation in heaven both begin and continue as you forgive all people.
We emphasized in our last video that forgiving all people isn't optional if you want to be forgiven by your Heavenly Father.
That's because unforgiveness means you're rejecting what our Lord Jesus accomplished on the cross on your behalf.
Biblically speaking, unforgiveness is like the sin of pride. And pride's a bad choice because God opposes the proud but shows favor to the humble.
God opposes the arrogance of unforgiveness. People who refuse to forgive others are vulnerable to Satan's trap of bitterness.
Forgiving from your heart keeps you from falling into the devil's snare.
We forgive so that we will not be taken advantage of by Satan, for we are quite aware of his schemes.
Realize that it's not the individual you're at odds with in hurtful situations. It's Satan and his demonic hordes that are churning up hurt feelings.
For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms.
Satan is a master deceiver. He deceives people who refuse to forgive by stirring up unrighteous thoughts like these.
Undervaluing and minimizing the sacrifice of Jesus on the cross.
Believing that their unforgiveness is righteous indignation toward an offender. In reality, it's unrighteous indignation because their pride has been wounded.
Believing that our Heavenly Father is punishing them with demonic torture rather than bringing them to repentance so they'll forgive and seek forgiveness.
Here's a pointed truth that perfectly describes the deceived plight of an unforgiving person. Once a person is deceived through unforgiveness, he does not recognize that he is deceived because he has been deceived.
Don't keep living deceived. Ask those who know you well if they detect any unforgiveness in you. Let's look at some very common sources of unforgiveness that cause emotional wounds but often get undetected.
The first is a wounded spirit. This is a third-party wounding of an unforgiving person who wasn't the one who was directly hurt.
Instead, this person listened to slander by an offended individual against a supposed wrongdoer.
A wounded spirit is unforgiving towards someone who never did anything to you.
People with a wounded spirit feel self-righteous, but actually, they're afflicted with the sin of unrighteous indignation.
That's why it's so important for you to refuse to listen to slander and gossip. From our Father's perspective, hearing slander and gossip is as sinful as speaking it.
This next emotional wound runs rampant in Christianity. It's the emotional wound wives feel because their husbands don't seek God's specific will for their family. This doesn't mean studying the Bible. It's much more serious than that. I'm referring to a husband's responsibility to his wife to seek God's will for them as a couple. Husbands, love your wives, just as Christ also loved the church, the called out ones, and gave himself for her that he might sanctify and cleanse her with washing of water by the word.
A husband washing his wife by the word means he's personally responsible to seek God's RHEMA, his specific will for his wife and his family.
There are many emotionally wounded women in Christianity because their husbands lack humility, the humility to live up to their responsibility to seek God's will and help their wives and families put God's will into practice.
Wounded emotions also afflict a husband whose wife fails to be his Ezer, the suitable helper to come alongside her husband. An Ezer is by no means a subservient role for a wife as a helper who's suited to her husband. Even God was called the Ezer of Israel. He was Israel's most suitable helper.
God intends a wife's responsibility to be the kind of loving support to her husband as God showed to Israel as their helper.
But many Christian men have become disillusioned about God's love for them because of the wives' attitude and actions.
These women want no part of the submissive heart of Sarah, nor the gentle and quiet spirit, which is precious in God's sight.
And the husbands withdraw into their man caves just to get away from all the home front chaos brought on by their wives.
Another source of emotional wounding begins in childhood and later in life hinders an individual from trusting their Heavenly Father.
We're referring to children whose father failed to keep his promises to them. Men can be very careless with their words.
They don't realize how much children trust anything they perceive as a promise to them by their father.
It wouldn't be an exaggeration to say that 90% of adults today suffer from fathers or other adults who didn't keep their word.
After my time in Vietnam, I served under a man who made God's word his way of life. He instilled in all his young officers his personal motto, "Your word is your bond."
Another way to put this is, don't say you'll do something if you're not going to follow through.
Let's summarize what we've discussed in these two videos on forgiving all others. We who follow Jesus as our Lord are forbidden to have unforgiving attitude against any person. They're made in God's image, and He has given us the grace to forgive them.
Do you appreciate the sacrifice of our Lord Jesus so that you can be reconciled to your Heavenly Father? If you do, then you can be compassionate toward the people who have offended you or let you down. You can recognize that they're prisoners to demonic influence and their own sin nature.
Please anchor this truth. No matter what you think about whether you're saved or not, we urge you to seriously consider Jesus' warning. If you refuse to forgive, you won't be forgiven by the Father until you do forgive from your heart.
We told you in an earlier video about the connection between trusting Jesus and being His outflow of living water. He who trusts in Me, as the scripture has said, out of his heart will flow rivers of living water.
Our Lord Jesus doesn't want polluted streams of bitter and unforgiving water representing Him in the world.
Until you can forgive everyone who ever hurt you, you won't be able to authentically represent and embody the enormity of His love for humanity.
As children of our Heavenly Father, we must be at the forefront of extending to mankind the love and forgiveness which is available through Jesus.
As we keep reminding you, our Lord Jesus sacrificed Himself for each one of them.